guys. It's Friday. Okay, Matt Towel Water. We have 5 Vinyasas today coming up. Each one will have a little fun buried inside, like a little treasure. Okay, so Barkin 5. I'm calling it Barkin Fit 5 because in each vinyasa there will be an option to kind of turn up the volume a little bit. So there'll be push-ups, there will be some abs, there will be some cardio, kind of worked into each vinyasa, usually on the second set. The fourth vinyasa only has one set, so. All right, so let's get ready to rumble. Okay, let's see who's here. Jen, Kathy, good morning. Barbara, Janet, Mary, Christine. Christine, I see you making progress at home with some of those funky balances and stuff, right? And Jean, hi. Hi, Lori. Good morning. Okay, so say hi to each other. I'm saying hi to everybody. And as always, thanking you for showing up. I show up for you, you show up for me, that's the way it works. We're getting cautiously optimistic that at some point, maybe by the end of the month, we can open in some fashion. So we're working on how that's gonna happen. Probably do a sign up. We're marking out the room to determine exactly how many people we can get in here and maintain proper social distance so that you guys can feel comfortable about being here. And if anyone has any suggestions or any ways that they can help, please reach out to us. We're also looking into getting some sort of like plexiglass in front of the computer area, the check-in area. So if anyone has any good contacts there, let us know. We're working on something, but if you have any info, let us know. Okay, so, and of course the contribution button is still up on the website because it is really making a difference for us. It's allowing us to even consider opening, and we will. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so we're gonna start in child's pose. We're doing 5 vinyasas, but we're gonna start in child's pose. So get there, and just know that within each vinyasa, there's gonna be a little something. My cues might be enough for you. Maybe you just don't really care if it's exact, whatever. But if you're not sure, just peek up towards your device, and I'll try to demo, give you as much verbal direction as I possibly can. Okay, so we're gonna start in child's pose. Good morning, Elaine. Okay, so it's Friday. Wow, another Friday, could you imagine that? Sunday is Mother's Day already. We went from St. Patrick's Day to Mother's Day already. Okay, so it's 2 minutes after, let's get going. If your head is not touching your mat, then just fold up your arms or your fists, like one potato, two potato, and make some contact on your third eye, okay? Hi, Donna, good morning. Hi, Debbie, Dory, hi, guys, okay.
Do take a moment just to focus on your intention, whatever that might be. Every day is a little bit different. But just know that you have 1 hour to devote to your yoga practice, but that 1 hour can change the rest of your day. So, think about what it is you want to accomplish on your mat and how it can serve you off your mat. Maybe it's just pausing to take a breath. Maybe it's listening to your body. Maybe it's knowing that you're stronger than you ever thought you were. Together, let's take 3 inhales and exhales. So draw the breath deeply into your nose and exhale, sigh it out. 2 more inhale. Exhale. on your last one, reach your fingertips all the way forward, and then exhale, sigh it out. Roll your hands over the right side and stretch out the left side of your body. Whatever feels good. If you like to rock the shoulders side to side, that's fine. And then walk your hands over the left side, do the same thing. So when we start practice, we're just asking for a little space. And come on back to center. Okay, come on up to seated, tucking your toes under. Let's stretch out the bottoms of the feet. Reach around your pinky toes out of the way. Pull the belly back up and in, shoulders down and back. If it's excruciating, put your hands down. And if you can, lean back a little bit. Get a little deeper stretch to the soles of the feet. It's going to really help for balance with things like crescent. So the second vinyasa is a lot of crescent pose. And you want that balance and that strength in the soles of your feet. But also start giving you a little bit of stretch to the quads and the hip flexors. Good. Come on back. Flap your feet around a little bit. Stretch it out. This is the one's favorite part. And then feet runs a cat-cow. Belly down, gaze up, shoulders. Move away from the ears as the tailbone lifts and the sternum presses forward. And then as you round and curl, you optionally tuck your toes and push, stretching out the feet just a little bit more. Belly down, gaze is up. Even though your belly is down, I want you to keep your core active. And then round and curl. And take a few rounds of cat-cow on your own. Adding some movement side to side, dancing lion, if you think that's going to help create the space that you need for your practice. So maybe clockwise, one or two times, or counterclockwise, one or two times. Pick with your palms so the fingertips face back, and lean back to stretch out the front part of the wrists. And then flip the palms over, stretch out the forearms. Really good, especially when you do lots of chaturangas. Shake your hands out. Really good. Let's roll, just roll through the shoulders a few times. So reach your right arm out to the side and then up. Bring it forward, down and around a couple of times. And then reverse it. Really reach. Reach all the way back like you're reaching for something in the back seat of your car. And then thread the right arm under. Take the right fingertips, crawl onto your left shoulder blade and drop the right shoulder down. If you like, you can reach the left arm forward. And then unthread. Reach your right arm up one more time. Cactus the elbow and twist through the spine. Right shoulder stacking above the left, gaze up toward the ceiling. Release it, put it down. Left arm, reach it forward. I'm sorry, reach it out. So just get the shoulder kind of released from the socket. Then reach it forward, down and around. A couple times. Notice if you need to soften the elbow. And then release it. Swing it back the other way. A couple times. Yeah. And then go ahead and thread it under. Take your left fingertips. Reach all the way around. See if you can't find your right shoulder blade. About half of a hug, yeah. And then drop the left shoulder down. And your option is to extend your right arm forward. Come on back up. Left arm reaches up. Cactus the elbow. Find the twist. Release. Come on back down. Touch your toes. Lift your hips. Down dog. Pull out your feet. Take your dog for a walk. So heel, toe, like a moonwalk. And then settle, make sure your feet are set properly, about hip distance, and hands are about shoulder width and even. Fingers spread nice and wide, your weight pushes back. Chest to thighs, belly in. Come high on your toes, notice the shoulders pull forward. Keeping the toes high, weight on the big and second toe, the ball of the foot. Push your chest back to your thighs. Your heels are high, your tail is high, your chest is pressing to your thighs. Engage your quads. Your head is neutral, biceps to ears. Send your heels over to the right side. Keep your shoulders square by pulling the left armpit towards your right foot. Good. Come over to the other side. Same thing. Right armpit, left foot. Keep your shoulders square. Come on back to center. Come high up on the toes and he likes to lean side to side, or release the fingertips and just finger paint on your mat. Bring your toes and heels together to touch. They don't have to be slammed together, which is pretty close. Tuck your chin. Take your fingertips, find the tops of your toes. Keep your chin tucked and glide your fingertips off the tops of your feet, points of the ankles, the shins. Find the bottoms of your knees and stop. Relax your shoulders, belly in. And then slowly make your way all the way back up. Your fingertips find the tops of your thighs. And then draw your hands to heart center, closing your eyes, bringing that gaze back to your third eye where you can reaffirm, reset, or change your attention.
Okay, now we're gonna get moving. Hi, Julia, long time, Jody, Kristen.
Okay, starting with our first vinyasa, starting on the score. Inhale, arms up, open the heart. Exhale, uttanasana, forward fold. Pedal it out, squat down if you need to. Widen the knees, drop the body through. First one, we're gonna take a little bit extra time just to warm up. And then fold in uttanasana. Looking up, right leg steps back to a lunge. Hold your nice little lunge on the fingertips if you need to. Shoulders down and back. Nice long line of energy from the crown of the head to the back heel. Engage your right leg. So your right quad is engaged, the back of the knee is lifted. Not a lot of weight on the fingers or the thigh. Palms down, left leg back, plank, hold. If your heels are low to the mat, walk your feet back, shift your chest and shoulders forward slightly. Find the tip of toes, hold, plank. Modifying on the knees if you need to. Let's do one push-up, chaturanga, down and up. Lower down halfway and hold, or knees, chest, chin. Upward facing dog or cobra. Again, using the knees, a little pit stop if you need it, and go to downward facing dog. Widen your feet and your hands, or whatever, the outside of your mat, and give it a pull. Back to downward facing dog. Right leg, pick it up. Bring the knee to the nose slowly. Step it through. Right leg forward during your lunge. If you need to, you drop the knees. Grab the leg and set it up. Then go ahead, drop the left knee, hands down. Your choice to come onto the thigh or up, Anjali Masana. And then release, hands down. Left foot steps forward and you fold at the top of the mat. Good, press down, inhale, arms up. Exhale, just going to lie back down. One more time, really quickly, right? Anything left, any sticky spots, go through them, pedal, squat, bounce. And then left leg back to your lunge. Holding a nice long lunge. Challenge yourself if you want by lifting up off the fingertips. Right thigh parallel. Can you reach your fingertips back, get your shoulders out of the ears, back leg is long, and straight. Okay, right leg is back here in plank. You can find your tippy toes, you can shift your weight forward slightly, make sure your hips aren't too high. You don't want to be in a down dog. And they're not sagging. You need to drop your knees. Chaturanga. Here's your push-up. Upward facing. Downward facing. So you have the option to use chest chin every time. You can skip it and lean in downward facing dog. Left leg, pick it up, bring your knee to your nose. Shifting the weight forward, left foot steps. You're back to your lunge, drop the knee. Your choice is to stay, climb up halfway, or arms up. Open heart. Release hands down, right foot steps forward and fold. Press down, rise up. We go seconds and we add a twist and we add those fit options. So exhale, uttanasana, forward fold. Right leg back, lunge. Right, left leg back, plank. First set, 10 push-ups. Drop the knees if you need to. Widen the arms if you choose. 10 push-ups, so 10. Five, four, three, two, one. If your hands are wide, please bring them back. Chaturanga, upward facing. And if you want one more push-up, find it on the way back. Downward facing dog. Breathe. Heart rate comes up, heart rate comes down with the breath. Right leg, pick it up, step it forward. Find your lunge. knee, hands down or up, Anjaneyasana. And then we go to the twist, left hand down, right hand up. You can keep the knee down or lift the back knee. Moving into side plank, your right leg comes back into side plank on your left hand. Dropping the left knee if you choose. You can stay or work the obliques, right arm threads under, and then reaches. Your other option would be to thread the right arm all the way under, drop to a right arm forearm plank, look up if you're not sure, and then switch left hand down, right hand up. Okay, so you have five, either scooping or switching from high plank to forearm plank. Go. You have five. Keep breathing, please. Four, this is my new trick. Three. Last two. Last one. Moving back to side plank. Bring the right knee forward. Back to your lunge. Two hands down. Left leg lifts. Steady slip. And left knee steps down. Press down, rise up, and go to the other side. And you exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen, left leg is back. Right leg is back, you're in plank. One more time, your option, 10 push-ups. So tricep push-ups or military push-ups, you can widen your stance. Try to stay off your knees this time, let's go. 10. Up your left leg, step it forward to your lunge, drop the left knee. It's your choice to stay, find the knee halfway, climb up, lift the chest, forearms up. Good, left hand down, right hand down, left hand up, lunge twist, lifting the back knee or not. And then moving into side plank. You can stay in side plank, you can drop the knee. You can just simply scoop with that left arm. Or five times, you switch from a right side plank to a left side forearm plank. Go. You can even do it all on your knees. Five. Four. So amplify or modify. Three. Two. Last one. You meet in that side plank. Left foot steps forward, back to your lunge with the twist, and then left hand down, right leg up, standing split, and the right foot steps down, fold. Good, press down, rise up, back to one. Open the heart, exhale down, Devasana spot, inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold, inhale, lengthen, walk, step or float back. Take your flow, or just knee, and downward facing dog. How are we doing, guys?
How are you going? Good. Good, good, good. Hi, Liv. All right.
Devasana Namaskar starts with crescent, so right leg steps forward. First step, put your hands in your hips, lay high on the back toes, and lift the arms to crescent pose. Shoulders down and back, thumbs back, belly in. Swing your arms back. Pull the knuckles first, down towards your left heel. Drop the shoulders, and then bow. You can drop the knee, choose. Stretch the shoulders, guys, belly in. Rise back to crescent, turn to face the back. Same thing, other side, crescent. You need to, hands to hips to get organized. And then arms back, stretch the shoulders, take a bow. Rising back, drop the knee, palms flat, palms crossed. Head to knee, Janu Sirsasana.
the kneeling salute. Inhale, rise, and exhale for back bend. Make sure the left knee stays over the foot as you lift the heart and arch back. Come back to center, tuck the toes and stand up. Face the front, bend the front, drop the back, and take a bow. Good, hands down, downward facing. The option is to add those vinyasas in between or not. Second set, there will be some more high intensity options. Okay, let's just do the same thing on the left side. So we're going to do full two sets, Devasana Namaskar. Left side, step forward, and rise to crescent. Of course, hands to hips is there if you need it. Left hip back, right hip forward, hips down or up. Go ahead, swing your arms back, stretch it out, and bow. So it should feel really good. Make sure that you keep switching the thumbs each time. Rise and face the back. Same thing, other side, crescent. Arms back, stretch and bow. Humble. Good, rise and drop the knee. Palms flat, thumbs crossed. Head to knee, rounding, curling. Inhale up, exhale back. Make sure the knee stays over the foot and the ankle. Lift up, reach up with your fingertips. Look at your thumbs. And dangle back. Back to center, tuck toes. Stand up, please, and turn to face the front. Bend the front, drop the back, and go ahead. Tap your head on your knee. Inhale as you rise. Really press down on that shin and lift up and find your back. So create the space so you can find the movement. And then hands down, down dog. So you can flow. You can take the vinyasa on one leg. It becomes kind of natural as you swing the leg back. Your option is to drop it down or not. And we knee back and now we're facing dog. Walk, step, jump, top of the mat. Press down, rise up, open the heart. Take a big breath, because round two is going to get a little intense. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift, fill it up. Exhale, release. Again, look up, walk, step, or jump back. If you want extra push-ups, take them or leave them. Double dip, breathe aloud. Down dog, breathe. Right side, pick it up, step it forward, come on up to crescent. Don't get comfortable, we're not staying. From crescent, hands down, right knee swings back and up. Five times, right leg forward. Rise to crescent, hands down, right leg back, one knee dog. Four more times, rise to crescent, hands down, right leg swings back and up. Three more times, right leg forward, rise to crescent. Hands down, right leg back. Right leg forward, rise to crescent. Hands down, right leg back, one more time. Right leg steps forward, rise, crescent. Hands down, right leg back, one leg dog. Right foot steps forward, rise to crescent, hold. Charge and reach. Hands to prayer. Twist right side. Rise back up, turn to face the back. Crescent pose. Facing the back. Go right to your twist. Hands to prayer. Twist left side. Back to crescent. Right knee down. Tuck and curl. Head to knee. Add the half split. So hands down. Shift back. Left foot forward. Come on up and take your back bend. Your option would be to release the right hand to the right heel. For like a half a camel. Face the front, please, bend the front, drop the back. Take a bow, head to knee. Stand and split, shift your weight back. I'm sorry, half split. Come on up, now find your back bend. Your option would be left hand, left heel. And then the hands come down, bring your right foot. Swing the right leg back and up and take your flow. One or two legs, upward facing, downward facing. Cool.
go left side. So pick the left leg up, step it all the way forward, and rise to crescent pose. So you can stay there.
Or on the first one, you can stay in downward facing dog, but we have five. So from crescent, hands down, left leg comes back and up. Bring it all the way forward, back to crescent. That's five. Swing the left leg back and up, step forward. That's four. One leg a dog, left leg is up. Crescent pose, that's three. Hands down, one leg dog, step forward. Two, hands down, left leg back. Step forward, rise to crescent. Good, hands down, left leg back. Last one, step forward, rise, crescent, hold. Breathe, hands to prayer. I'm sorry, hands forward, charge. And then prayer hands on your twist. Maybe you split the arms of vine. Second time around. Okay, back up, facing the back. Go right to crescent. Charge and reach. Hands to prayer, twist. Left elbow, right thigh. You can always drop the knee if you choose. Open. Vine, inhale for full. Come on back up and drop the knee. Hands to prayer. Head to knee. Find that half split. Are you ready for the full split? Not staying long. Come on back up. This time, your option is right hand, left heel. So finding a twist. Hopefully, we got a fall over. Come up, tuck the toes. Stand up, face in front. Bend the front, drop the back. And tuck and curl. Try to get your head to tap the knee so your knee is right in that third eye, right where you set your intention, lock it in. Shifting back, half or full split. Rising back to that kneeling position. Rising up your back, and this time your left hand can reach back to your right heel. Cartwheel the hands, left leg flips back and up. Option to put it down or not. Find your vinyasa. Knee down, facing dog. And breathe. You can breathe again. Alright, walk, step, and flip. You're at the top of the mat. And you fold. Press down, rise up. Each time is an opportunity to open your heart. Just take a little bigger back then. And then exhale, Uttanasana. Vinyasana number three, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Walk, step or float back. Adding push-ups. Upward facing and downward facing. Starting in warrior one, right side. So right foot steps forward, drop the back heel. And rise with strength, the strength of a warrior. If you need to or choose to, hands to hips. Lean forward a little, right hip back, left hip forward. Really move to the back leg, back glutes engaged, warrior one. So stay for like three nice long rounds of breath, warrior one, and get low. Don't rush through these poses. These are the foundations of our yoga practice. Right, crescent, warrior one, warrior two. Take another big inhale. You might need to adjust your stance a little bit. And let's take it to warrior two. So if you have a mirror in front of you, try to get the right thigh to come to parallel. You can look at it, make sure the knees are on the angle. Drop your hips, and then reach front to back. The outside of your left foot should be rooting down, and the inside of your left leg is lifting up. Your feet are opposing, right? They're trying to pull together. So inner thighs are active. There's working strength and flexibility. Take another breath here, warrior two, and then reverse it, peaceful warrior. If you need to or choose to, put your fingertips behind your head. Lift your elbow up. Get your left shoulder out of your ear. Good, come back to warrior two. Hot triangle, right elbow, right knee. Reach down and stretch up, gazing up. You absolutely need to rest your elbow on your thigh, but make it more of a stepping stone, not so much of a crutch. You can also hold lightly, and I repeat lightly, like really, really, really lightly on your ankle. Take one more breath, try your pose, and then hands down, downward facing dog. One leg or two, and the option is to flow through. Upward facing. Remember, you can always double dip, you catch that extra turn of the push up, downward facing dog. Please breathe. On the left side, we start with warrior one. So drop back here. Your back foot's at like 30-ish degrees. Warrior one. Baby hands to hips. Lean forward a little bit. Okay, that softens the flexor so you can move it. Left it back, right hand forward. Then your arms can come back up. Crescent. I'm sorry, warrior one. We're holding warrior one for three breaths. Find that warrior energy, lower your hips. Root through the back edge of that right foot, and then lift the inside of your leg up. When your legs are apart, anytime your legs are apart, guys, find that Mula Bandha, that lower lock, that root lock. Draw the energy up and in.
Take another breath, and then go to warrior two, left side. Drop your hips, send the energy to the outside of your right foot. Your shoulders out of your ears, use your obliques to hold your arms up. Take one more breath, and then find some peace as you lift your left arm up and over. The right shoulder moves away from you, so really reach to the outside, that back heel, the right heel. You feel the stretch on the left side, the obliques, the intercostals. Come back to warrior two, and then find your hot triangle. Hot triangle, like a Bikram triangle. Barkin triangle, hot triangle. Left elbow, left knee. Look down, make sure your left fingertips are pointing towards your big and second toe. Not your heel, not behind. The right hip is lifting, drop it down. And of course, you can modify bracing on the thigh or holding lightly on the shin. Good, hands down, down dog. Left leg to the back and up. Option is to flow. So if you want to work that sweat and you want to take that sweaty selfie when done with class, do the extra push-ups. Even if you're on your knees. Okay, we're at the halfway point of the vinyasas. So halfway in, halfway out. Take a breath and downward facing dog. Walk your hands back to your feet and just hang there for a second. Slide your hands into your feet, Padmasana from the front. Arms. Good. Take your hands out. Toe heel your feet together. Soften the knees. Find chair pose. You're at the back of your mat. Good. Inhale. Rise and reach. Right grabs left. Find that half moon stretch. Your option is to soften the knees and lift your right leg up. Good. Come on back to center. Straighten your legs. Left grabs right. Take that half and then stretch over to the left side. You can stay there or soften through the knees. Keep pulling to the left. The left leg is straight and then it lifts up. Good, put it down. Back to center. Adding in a back bend. Here you can add hands to hips, low back. Good, rise and reach. Exhale, Uttanasana, forward fold. Walk back out, downward facing dog. In revolving triangle, right leg, pick it up and step it forward so your toes are under your nose. Pivot the back heel, hands to hips, inhale, rise. Square it off by using your hand to slice your right hip back. Literally take your hand and pull it back, left arm up. Exhale, hinge, maybe stopping at the tabletop. The left hand goes to your shin, foot floor block, water bottle, and we rotate. Keep your head screwed on straight, guys, as you keep the right hip back, lift the right shoulder up. The feet press down and apart, the inner thighs pull them back together, and you rotate. If the right shoulder is still pointing down, you're much better off keeping your head on your hip and trying to get the shoulders to rotate. Lifting up the arm is just raising the flat, right? Take one more breath there, and then hands down, down dog. Add in the flows if you want them, take them or leave them. Second set, we let on. Left side, pick it up. Step it forward, right under the face. Right under your heart. Heel under the heart. Hands on hips, inhale, rise. Left hand on tip, right hand up, and hinge. So right away you feel pressure through the feet. That's why it's really important to warm up the feet. Your feet are pressing down and apart, and your inner thighs are scissoring together. Super active through the feet and the legs. The hanging stand on the hip, use your hand to draw your hip back so your spine stays long. You don't want to C-curve over to the side of the mat. Take your time in this pose. Engage your quads. You should be working hard. One more breath. How heavy are you on that right hand? Left hand down, left leg up, and your option is to stay or to play, and we go downward facing dog. Okay, walk, step, or jump, top of the mat, press down, rise up. Second set, third vinyasa, open the heart, exhale, uttanasana forward fold. Inhale, lengthen, exhale. Let it go. Just dump it out. Good. Inhale. Walk, step, or float. Upward facing. Down dog. And you breathe. Right leg side forward, warrior one. Inhale, rise. Get organized. Get nice and low in warrior one. Right hip back. Left shoulder forward. Open to warrior two, and stay. Get nice and low, make sure the energy is up and in. Good, bring your hands behind your head. Try not to straighten out the right leg as you tap right elbow, right thigh or knee. Do one or two for practice. Can you keep your left hip down? Your legs stay stable, right? We go 10, 9, belly in, 8, 7, drop those hips, guys. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Warrior 2, reverse. Now stretch out that right side. Bending the right elbow, maybe lifting the right elbow all the way up. Good. Back to warrior 2. Triangle or Trikonasana. Remember your option is to rest the elbow or hold the thigh, or hold the calf. Left arm swings down and around. We can go once or twice in each direction, just like our warm-up. Side angle pose. You can put your right hand on the floor, leave it on your thigh. Left fingertips reach forward, gaze is up. Option to bind half or full. Option to fly. Step forward, look forward. Come up on the left, the right shoulder, and lift up the two bird high rise. Slowly release. You want to try to reverse, Christine? I saw you, girl. Look forward. Lift the left leg up. Oh. All right. Let that elbow lie. Hands down, down dog. And you take your phone. And move to the left side. Left side, warrior one. Left to back, right hip forward. You might need to spin that back heel to the back of your mat just a bit. Warrior one, warrior two. So left side, warrior two. Hips are low, left thigh seeking parallel. Good wing on the outside of that back foot, hands behind your head. So just like your fingertips behind your ears, but pull your elbows back. Right, spread your wings, left elbow, left thigh. Do one or two just for practice. Keep your hips low. Right thigh stays super engaged. Let's go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Each time you lift the right elbow up. 5, 4, left elbow, left thigh. Last two, last one, warrior two. Reverse it. Now you stretch out the left side. Back to warrior two. Triangle or Trikonasana. Hot triangle.
You can rest the elbow on the thigh. You just don't want to put all your weight there. Let's see. I guess you can't see me. I'm too close. Okay, then swing the right arm down and around. 1, 2, 3 times. Side angle pose. So that means your right arm now comes from 12 o'clock to 3 o'clock or 9 o'clock, depending on which way you're looking at it. Your option is to bind, half or full. And if you fly in, do it on the other side. If this is your bad side, or your awkward side, or your challenging side, try harder. Okay, don't give up. Give more. Try it. Bird of paradise, balance and split. And we'll find our way on your path to downward facing dog. Right? Many paths in one destination, right? One truth. Downward facing dog. Breathe. Anytime you need to, you know you drop to your knees. Let's go to a revolving triangle. Here in the second set, pick your right leg up for one legged dog. Come high on your back toes. So usually I'm encouraging you to drop your heel, and I want you to come high on your toes. Work the calf. Good, now point the toe, open the hip, bend the knee, and stretch it out. Look over under your right shoulder, lift the right knee up. Good, square it off. And step the right foot through. Hands on hips, rise. Revolving triangle. Left arm up. Come on down, rotate part, root dodge, Uttanasana. You are welcome to stay here. Move back to down over child's pose. Or switch hands, come to half moon, Arya Chandrasana. Right hand down, left hand up. So from here, we're going to move to Shiva squats. It's kind of when you tap your knee behind the standing knee. It's a one-legged squat. Go to a standing split. So two hands down, left leg up. And then look forward, soften the right knee, and tap your left knee behind. Keep your hands down for a set. Your option as we move through five of these is going to bring your hands to prayer as you look forward. And hands down, back to that standing split, left knee tapped behind the right knee for your Shiva squat. Okay, let's go. Five. Maybe just swing the leg back and up. Four. Three. Two. One. Step the left foot back. Now step the right leg back and up and take your flow. So it all came from a revolving triangle. But do the same thing on the other side. Okay, left side. Left leg comes up and one leg go. Come high on your right toes. First, square the left hip, toes point down. Right heel high, chest to thigh. Now point the toe, lift the leg up. Point the toe, bend the knee. Stretch it out, look over under your right shoulder. Square it off. Step it through, prepare for revolving triangle. Left leg is forward, hands on hips, rise. Left hand to hip, right arm up, inhale, exhale, hinge. You might need a block or use your water bottle. Wherever your right hand is, it should not be heavy. The left fingertips are reaching up. Trying to pull your right hand up off whatever it is, even if you're lightly on the fingertips. Maybe you can get the fingertips to hover by engaging your core and your inner thighs, using the energy from your feet. So, you know, you can say that you can go to down dog, or switch hands and go to Arya Chandrasana, left hand down, right hand, right leg up. How heavy are you on that left hand? Send the energy out through your right fingertips. Really reach up. And as you do, notice how the energy lifts, draws up the inside of your left thigh. Extend the right leg. Flex the foot, push. And notice how the energy comes out of the crown of your head. Good. Two hands down, standing split. We're going to go Shiva squats. Now your right leg is up. So soften the knee, look up, and tap your right knee behind your left. Your option is going to be to bring your hands to prayer. Hands down, right leg up. So it might just be a warrior three supported for you. Maybe you're just swinging the leg back and up. Maybe you're already in down dog. Any way you choose is cool. Let's go five.
You find that single leg swapping your hands to parallel forward. Good, hands down. Right leg is up. Step it back. Swing your left leg all the way back and up. And take your flow. Upward facing. Downward facing. Good. Walk, step, or jump. Top of the mat. Toe heel your feet out. Hands to prayer. Awesome. Take a quick step if you need it. Let's find a twist. Right hand in front of the right chin. Look up. Option to bind. Option to fly. So now you're binding in front of the right chin, not underneath. Come on up. Come on down. Back to Malasana hands prayer. Left side. So this is sort of your optional rest. Maybe you're binding in front of the left. Look down, hips up. Step the right foot in. Come high on your left toes. And then lift up. You need that little bandha. Slowly lower down. Malasana. Good, hands down, hips up. Please don't have those feet together. Drop your seat, fingertips sweep, chair pose. Get low. Heart high for three. Two, and one, open, rise and reach. Exhale, you come down. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, walk, step, or jump. We're in the fourth vinyasa, upward facing, down low, and you're breathing. If you're anything like me, we've been pretty heavy, although I'm talking my way through it. Dandi Manika Kaptapada Jani Shashasana, standing step leg forward into knee. Right foot steps forward, hands to prayer. Roll it up. And then roll it down. You can soften the right knee, biceps to ears. Soften the grip, put your hands aside your right foot. Most importantly, get your head and your knee to touch. Take a breath. Take two breaths. And bring your hands together for prayer, squeeze your thumbs so tight they turn right. Exhale, inhale, rise. Turn to the back. Oh no, sorry, stop in the middle. I forgot. Stop in the middle, five-pointed star. Turn your toes out a little bit. Good, dropping into goddess pose, elbows to knees. Then come back up to that five-pointed star. We have 10. Go, so like sumo squats, 10. 9, 8, 7, you can skip them, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bring your arms overhead, now continue your journey to the back, tuck your chin and roll down, please breathe, head to knee, left side.
Ah, so good you guys, awesome.
Arms behind you with your right leg up, so your variation of warrior three or airplane pose with your arms behind you. And then rise to a standing staff pose. So pull the right knee up, arms up, extend your right leg. If you're not sure, take a quick peek. I can hold that for you. And then come on back. Hands behind you, right leg is out. Okay, we have three.
Yep, arms out. Five-pointed star. Then you're going to swing your arms in and out. If you want, you can take it into a jumping jack. Ready? 10, 9, deep squat. 8, 7, 6, 5, like a sumo jack. 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on up. Bring your hands behind you. Turn to the front. Pyramid pose. Right legs in front. You can stay there or lift your left leg up. And we rise 3 times that standing staff pose. Arms come up, leg comes out. For 3, 2, 1. Go back to pyramid pose. Hands down, left foot steps forward, go padasana from the back. Scoop your heels up, drop your head, lift your butt. Hands to feet pose. Almost done, guys. Good, release toes on your feet out to hip distance. Padasana, peace on fingers, drop your toe. Exhale, fold, elbows out. Shake the head, yes and no. Hands down, crow pose. So malasana would be your option. If malasana is too deep, hands down, hips up. You can use a block, a white ball, a double handle pot. Crow pose, palms down, bring your feet close together, widen the knees. Claw your mat, look forward, lean forward. Toes touch, heels up. Hips up, belly in. Pull your heels to your glutes and your glutes to the ceiling. Walk, step, or jump back. Take your flow. Downward facing. Walk, step, or jump. Top of the mat, we meet there. Exhale. Inhale, rise and reach. Hands to heart, breathe. Fifth vinyasa. Let's finish it up. Okay, it's called the one-legged flow. Let's do it. Okay, arms up. Exhale. Uttanasana, forward fold. Good. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale. Let it go. Inhale, look up. Walk, step, or jump. Vinyasa. Downward facing dog. Pick up your right leg. Flex point. Bend and stretch. Keep your left heel down this time. Stretch out the left hamstring. Good. Square it off. And come forward into a three-legged plank. Stay there. Take your right leg. It should be up. Drop the left knee if you need to. Move it out to the side for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right leg is up, right leg is down. Left leg, pick it up. Left point, bend, stretch. Keeping your right heel down this time. Shoulder square, look over under your right shoulder. Good, square it off, come forward. Do the push-up triangle. Did we forget it on the other side? I don't know. And then left leg just taps out to the side for 10, 9, 8, you can drop the right knee, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, left leg is up, left leg is down, downward facing dog. Right away, walk, step, jump, top of the mat. Press down, rise up, open the heart. Maybe your biggest breath in yet. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen, stay with me. Exhale, fold. Inhale, walk, step, or jump. Ready, Chaturanga, or Bhumukha. Drop knees, child pose, peaceful warrior. Here, a few breaths. Keep your head down, no thinking, no blinking, no drinking, no waking, no whining. Although I have to take a drink so I can speak. Take one more breath. Joining our energy together. Finding the intention if it has slipped away. Okay, downward facing dog. Ready? Right leg is up. Left point, bend, stretch. Option to flip your dog. Open your heart.
any forward and stay. Okay, we have running now. 10 to the front and 10 side to side. Ready, go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now side to side. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right leg up. Knee to nose. Swing it back. Come forward. Ready. Triangle. One leg it up. Stay on the toes. One leg down dog. Put it down and breathe. Heart rate comes up. Your breath brings it down. Same thing other side. You know that's the beginning of the end, right? All right, let's go left side, pick it up. Flex point, bend, stretch. Come behind the toes and flip your dog. It's an option. Flip it all the way around to that counter pose, so it's a variation of your side plank. Good, right hand down. Left leg swings back and up. Bring your knee to your nose. You're running at 10 to the front, 10 side to side. Go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Side to side. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Left leg is up. Knee to nose. Johnny, that's awesome. Swing it back. Come forward, ready. Triangle. One leg it up, you're on your toes. One leg it down. Downward facing dog. Walk, step, or jump, take a seat. Take a drink and wipe your sweat. Meet me seated. So good, you guys. Bark and fly, never disappoints. There's so much to do in that sequence. So much you can do in that sequence, right? Whew. Hopefully you guys are breaking a sweat. Take your sweaty selfie. Post it on your Instagram story. Tag YogaFlex NY. Tag YogaFlex Locust Valley. Tag Morning Atticus. Look at this fitness this morning. Okay, on Sunday, the more you post, the more chances you have to win a free month at YogaFlex and a one-on-one session with Marnie. I would maybe suggest doing that first. All right. Your feet are about a foot or two, your heels a foot or two away from your glutes. Take your knees, lean back a little bit, tuck your chin, so it's like a cat pose. And then using your body strength, roll your shoulders down about back, push your belly in, like a seated cow pose. Just go back and forth, kind of toggling. Stretching up the spine, 3, 2, and 1. Gonna hug your knees in. You can keep your feet down, keep your shins parallel to the floor, or straighten them out. We have goal pose. Biceps to ears, if you wanna really work it, or arms parallel, so your arms are like the water, right? Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. Now slowly tuck your chin around your spine. You come down, keep your legs up. And slowly lower down, hands behind the head. Release your hands. Shavasana. So hands behind the head often helps to support the neck. It was the last few inches when we come down. All right, seal kicks. If you're not familiar, look up. You're holding this sort of hollow boat, this kind of canoe shape. Flexing the feet to keep some length in the hamstrings, and you switch. And you switch. Not too fast. The left leg hovers, the right leg hovers, let's go. 10, gazing up. 9, belly's in. 8, 7, 6, 5, I love slow kicks. 4, 3,
Lock in the new space. Hold on to the new strength. Moving through center, to the left, knee to the right. If you notice that there are any points of tension, linger there for a moment or two. Send the breath there and ask for some release. Just ask. Ask nicely. Sometimes you try to push and force. And really what we need to do is ask nicely and choose to allow. Come on back to center. Pull your knees in. One more time. Widen the knees. Either knees to armpits or happy baby. Big hug, grab your opposite elbows, squeeze, some self-love. Place your hands down, your legs, up the imaginary wall. Let's hold it for about 20 seconds. Get the blood flowing, draining that fresh oxygen in your blood.
So, so good, you guys.
So what's today, Friday? What do you have? 4 o'clock. I think we have fawn at 4. Oh my God. Inferno. And then we have, down tomorrow at 10. The yoga, who's doing the yoga hit? And Saturday at 4. Elena. Mother's Day, Sunday, you guys. I'm going to be in here. No, boot camp. Okay, way, way, way back one on Mondays, I taught the boot camp class. Then Dana and I taught it. And then Dana and Marnie taught it. And now Marnie teaches. Okay, so we're going to do boot camp on Sunday, and according to most people's calculations, Sunday is day 50. So you can expect 50 of lots of things. So every day is a new day. Take this day, Friday, this Friday, in case you forgot what day it is, to reset. Look forward, not back. Make sure you hydrate well. Have a beautiful rest of your day. Thank you so much for your contributions. You can still do so on the website. The PayPal button there. Don't forget, take your sweaty selfies. Post it on Instagram. If you're not on Instagram, send a picture, Facebook, whatever. I'll repost it. Okay? Tag YogaFlex, YogaFlex NY, YogaFlex Lotus Valley, Marnie, and tag 2 friends. Okay, have a fabulous Friday, you guys. Namaste.